Welcome to Lunchbox Sessions, bite-sized industrial training.
Hello, this is Carl from lunchboxsessions.com. In this video, we will examine the brake pedal valve, the slack adjuster, and the basic functions of the brake piston against the brake discs. This is all happening inside the wheel spindle housing for a fairly popular model of motor grader. To get a better feel for how these components are working together, let's start by zooming in a little bit. Now that we're zoomed in and only seeing half of the brake spindle, that's great because that's really all we need to have to get a good feel for how this system functions. Let's just get started by stepping on the brakes. As the operator pushes down on the brake pedal, it pushes down on a rod that compresses a couple of springs in the top of the brake valve. I'm going to take my foot off the brake and we'll start again. What you see is that rod that leaves the bottom of the brake pedal does not directly operate the spools inside the valves. It merely tensions a couple of springs. And if you're watching the spools inside the brake valve, and by the way, this particular brake valve is very popular with front-end loaders, very popular with graders, used in lots of models of machines. It has two valves in it that set up your brake pressure. And so we're only interested in the upper half. That's the only half of the valve that we have connected to the slack adjuster. Well, as the operator applies more and more braking force, what you notice is that the spools pop open and pop shut for just a moment, bringing through available brake pressure from the left that is stored in accumulators and moving it into the slack adjuster. And so the brake pedal becomes a force regulating control by virtue of the fact that it is essentially a pressure reducing valve. To understand pressure reducing valves better, look for any of our videos that cover the topic of the pressure reducing valve. And what you're basically seeing with this brake pedal valve is that type of behavior. So every time the operator steps on the pedal a little further, saying, hey, I need more braking force, I'm going too fast, you see that the valve just pops open and pops shut for just a split second. And that's how it has to be. Otherwise, for any amount of hold value from the operator's boot, the entire available highest brake pressure would come through from the left to the right. And perhaps the operator only wants partial braking force, just wants to slow down a little bit. It's all about how hard do we want to force the brake discs together. Inside the wheel spindle housing is a set of rotating discs and a set of stationary discs. And without a three-dimensional image, it's hard to see, but half of the discs are prevented from rotating. They belong to the outside of the spindle, and half are on the inside of the spindle, so that as those discs are forced against each other, there's more and more friction to provide that braking force. And really, it's not a flow application, is it? When you notice what's happening as the operator pushes down on the pedal, perhaps you see flow arrows on the line from the brake valve to the slack adjuster, but for only a brief second. This is really not a consumer of flow, this circuit. Once those brake discs make contact with each other, from there on in, it's just how much force do you want to use? How much pressure from the hydraulic system do you want to create the braking force, that friction of moving disc against disc? That's really all that's happening. Moving over to have a look at the slack adjuster, what we see is that there is a large piston and a small piston. And when the operator steps on the brake, the first thing that happens is the large piston pushes out flow and moves it into the brake disc housing. But really, again, there's very little flow. And when the operator takes his foot off the brake pedal, the pressure in the brake piston is relaxed and fluid is returned to the yellow area on the left side of the large piston. left or right side. We're only dealing with the left side of the slack adjuster. We only have one of four wheel spindle housings that are typically on a grader. We're only showing one of four in this video. Okay, so that's just giving you a basic idea. When you take your foot off the brake, the brakes return a small amount of fluid to the slack adjuster that makes up for any wear in the discs and stores the right amount of fluid for the next application. Well, let's say the brake discs are badly worn. I can achieve that by clicking a switch here. You watch the brake discs at the top of the screen and notice that they've just moved farther apart. This simulates the idea that we've worn down the brake discs. Well, watch what happens this time as the operator steps on the brake pedal. If that large piston makes it all the way to the end of the slack adjuster chamber, that might not be enough fluid to get the braking that you need done. Perhaps you weren't done yet applying force for a higher level of brake disc friction, a higher braking force. So watch that small piston. We're watching the one on the left side of the slack adjuster as the operator pushes down farther. Did you see it pop open a few times? That is essentially a sequence valve that pops open only if the pressure from the brake pedal valve becomes higher. Coming from the brake pedal valve, that pressure is higher than what is on the output side of the slack adjuster. In that case, that sequence valve pops open and puts a makeup quantity of fluid into the brake piston for the wheel spindle housing. All right, that's a basic introduction to hydraulic brakes as they apply to a fairly popular model of motor grader. It's essentially the same for a lot of wheel loaders as well. Thanks for watching.
We have hundreds of interactive resources like this live schematic, so you can try out your wild ideas without blowing anything up. Get started at lunchboxsessions.com.